In this week's space news, Stoke Space has successfully conducted a hot-fired test of a rocket engine on their new vertical test stand. Vast Space, the company focused on commercial space stations, has constructed a test stand to pressure test their station modules. Meanwhile, InnoSpace from South Korea has shared an umbilical separation test via their X account. Over in Spain, PLD Space is pushing full steam ahead with the manufacturing of their Muira 5 orbital rocket. And lastly, RFA, that's Rocket Factory Augsburg, has posted photos showcasing their ongoing progress with the RFA One launch vehicle. Okay, let's get started. Stoke Space successfully hot-fired its first stage rocket engine on a new vertical test stand at their Moses Lake, Washington facility on Thursday, an event described as a very big deal for this four-year-old startup. The company is on a mission to develop a new generation of fully reusable rockets and space vehicles, aiming for them to operate with the frequency of aircraft. This test was significant because it was the first hot fire of their Block 2 Stage 1 engine, employing a particularly challenging engine architecture known as full-flow stage combustion. Only two entities globally, Stoke and SpaceX, have managed to successfully develop engines using this technology. This test represents the culmination of some very hard work across many different teams at Stoke and will serve as the basis for much learning to come. Stoke's Stage 1 engine is a liquefied natural gas, liquid oxygen engine capable of producing 100,000 pounds of thrust. Can't test an engine without a test stand, and this one's a beauty, Lapsa said on X after Thursday's test. Gorgeous clean burn using all the flows. Okay, on to our next story about a US company building commercial space stations. Vast builds test stand for its space modules. Vast Space, a US commercial space station company, is finalizing their new test stand in Mojave. They are currently developing Haven 1, a single module space station, with plans for a larger Haven 2 in 2028, which they hope NASA and other space agencies will use once the International Space Station is deorbited. This newly constructed test rig is engineered to mimic the loads and internal pressures that Haven 1's primary structure will endure during its ascent and while in orbit. Through this simulation of flight conditions, Vast Space will gather essential strain and deflection data during the testing phase. In further news about Vast, they have just completed their primary structure qualification article after finishing the final weld. This structure is now prepared for painting, window and hatch integration before being sent for pressure and load testing at their Mojave, California test site. Okay, on to our next story on a South Korean space startup. InnoSpace completes Seperation test. InnoSpace recently posted a brief video on the X platform showcasing an umbilical separation test. The umbilical system is crucial as it maintains the supply of propellant to the rocket until just before launch. This is necessary because cryogenic liquids can warm up and vaporize, requiring the rocket's fuel and oxidizer tanks to be continuously topped up. Just prior to launch, these pipes must disconnect automatically and without leaks. InnoSpace's test confirmed that this disconnection can be executed cleanly and swiftly. The post stated, "Done and dusted. Hanbit Nano's umbilical system, which supplies fuel, oxidizer, and high-pressure gases, has cleared a major milestone. Testing verified that the onboard and ground plates separate cleanly and without leaks." In other news from InnoSpace, they have just announced a change to the schedule for the upcoming launch of their Hanbit Nano vehicle, their first orbital vehicle. The launch date moves from March 2025 to July 2025 due to component supply delays and the ongoing construction of the new test facility. Okay, onto our next story on a Spanish space startup. Muira 5, full speed ahead with manufacturing. PLD Space is busy manufacturing the structures for the Muira 5 orbital rocket. Production is in full swing. The primary structure is made of aluminium using state-of-the-art machining, bending, and welding techniques. Each component undergoes rigorous testing, including X-ray analysis, looking for any defects. After a quality check, they go on to their custom-built test beds. And while we're talking about PLD Space, they recently received 11 million euros to boost their Muira 5 launch base in Kourou, French Guiana. This is the same spaceport used by Ariane 6. In total, they have received 16 million euros in investment for their launch complex, located at the European Spaceport in Kourou, French Guiana. Okay, before we move on to our final story this week, let's touch on Sierra Space, the company behind the Dream Chaser cargo vehicle, which is contracted to transport cargo to the International Space Station. They recently shared a photo on X of their Shooting Star cargo module, which attaches to the rear of the Dream Chaser, increasing its cargo capacity to the ISS. This module is currently in the final stages of testing at NASA Kennedy in Florida, while the construction of their second and third cargo modules progresses at their Dream Factory in Colorado. Now, let's move on to our final story this week. RFA has shared photos showcasing their progress this year. They are currently constructing their second RFA One launch vehicle following the destruction of the first in a pad accident at Saxeford Spaceport earlier this year. One photo offers a rare glimpse inside the tank of the RFA One. These tanks, made from stainless steel, are remarkably thin at only 1.2 millimeters. This thickness is sufficient to handle the flight pressures required while also being robust when not under pressure. Why choose stainless steel? Well, it's cost effective, ideal for mass production, and importantly, reusable. RFA plans to reuse the first stage in future missions. The next photo shows the second stage arriving at Saxeford Spaceport in July of this year. This stage made its journey from Sweden to Scotland, stopping at RFA's headquarters in Germany, all within a standard shipping container. In the following photo, we see both the second and third stages together. The third stage, known as Redshift OTV, and OTV stands for Orbital Transfer Vehicle, is essentially the final delivery stage, precisely positioning satellites into the specific orbits required by customers. In additional photos, we witnessed the construction of RFA's launch pad at Saxeford, Scotland. Work began in December 2022, and the image shows the lower structure of their launch stool, which was built by the maritime industry. This ensures the launch stool is stable, durable, and resistant to salt water, qualities essential for withstanding the harsh conditions in Shetland. One particular photo, captured with an analog camera by a team member, blends the innovation of stainless steel tanks and staged combustion engines with the nostalgic charm of traditional photography. RFA commented on this photo. "We're kicking off the day with a breathtaking sunrise over our launch site at Saxeford Space. A reminder that the sun rises again and again, even after darker nights. Looking at you, S1002. We will be back soon." Let's hope RFA manages to successfully launch their RFA One in 2025. Okay, that's it for this week. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.